Welcome to Toy Hill Studio. My name is Kendall Kessler. I put up painting demos and studio tours, and please check out my intro video. In 2 minutes, you can find out all about me, where I'm from, where I'm going, what my goals are. Last time, I did a very creative painting, skyline beauty painting of Pittsburgh, and I decided I'm going to move on to something else now. But I know it's kind of hard to see, but I used tissues in this very abstract sky. Something that I don't normally do because I'm an oil painter and I don't do a lot of water media. I do them for the YouTubes because I can do them very quickly. And I was real pleased at the wonderful patterns that came out. So this time I'm going to do a small painting, which I think is probably going to be what most people call abstract, what artists call non-figurative or non-objective, and probably not have any recognizable shapes. Now, if some come up, I might turn it into something, my suggestion series. If you watch some of my YouTube, you know, sometimes I like to just paint in a very abstract expressionist manner, and then as the forms appear that I can see very nebulously, I bring them out. It's a really great experience. So I'm going to use tissues in this one, and I've got large and small, and I'm going to see what happens. And since, as I said, I'm not, although I feel like very proficient in water media, it's not my main area. I am an oil painter. I found that the few times that I've done this, and it's been very few, it works better when I really get some paint on there. If I just put in a little bit, it tends not to do much. Probably because I'm just not real experienced in this kind of painting. There's just all kinds of fascinating textural effects that painters can get. I mean, there's just no limit to it. And I don't want to get it too thick or too thin. Oh, for once I'm going to remember, since right at the beginning, there will be a link to this painting at the end of the video. I'll link to my Etsy shop website and other sites that have my work. I want people to know that right up front, because I certainly want people to click on other things. Okay, this is going to dry kind of quickly, so maybe I probably ought to go ahead and take one of the tissues and just see what happens. I'm going to go into the different kinds of textures that artists use. Oh, cool. This is a cool effect. I can see why water mediums like to use this. Now you can, I guess you could do stuff like this in oil paints. There's so many things you can do, but it's not typical. It's usually the traditional manner of handling oil paint is to go from thin to thick. And for me, I do that, but I get real thick at the end. It gets to what we call impasto, where we really have the paint just sitting up. You can just really see the brushwork, and that's the way I really like it. That's my favorite way to paint. But there, I want to get into the different kind of textures. I tried real hard when I taught at Radford University to explain art to people, because it's been my experience that so many people have a very limited understanding. And it's not to criticize, it's just that it's a very complicated study, and there's so much more to it than making pictures of things. But a lot of people I've noticed are only impressed if they see something that looks like a photograph, not knowing that a lot of artists can do that. I can do that. I'd be glad to do it for you for a commission. It's not as hard as it looks. And a lot of artists don't do that because they like to get a lot of different kinds of textures apart from what they're looking at. This is cool. I'm gonna use a little bit bigger one this time. And of course, all of them fell on the floor, but I've got the box over there. Oh, neat. Now see that one, you might not be able to see it, but it looks kind of like a weird bird. Yeah, I have a feeling I'm gonna be going back and forth and back and forth into this one. Okay, explaining the different kinds of textures. When an artist reproduces a texture that you see, you know, as much as you can do, like reproducing a photograph, that is what we call simulated texture. They're simulating the texture that you see. In other words, water looks like water, fur looks like fur, sand looks like sand, so forth. Okay, that's one type of texture. Now, when an artist uses what the material, the medium, the paint, whatever they're using, to come up with textures that are because of what they're using, that's called invented. That's what I like to do. I like to work between simulated and invented. So my oil paintings, they look like what you see, but they have things that I've added. They have expressions that I've added in the way I've handled the texture and the color. All right, then there's abstract. Okay, abstract is not, in texture, it's not really talking about shapes. What we're talking about in texture is taking a bunch of blocks maybe and putting them together, and it's supposed to be cinder blocks, but it doesn't have the texture cinder blocks. It's just the outlines, just the lines. Okay, that's an abstract texture, taking textures and turning them into abstract patterns. All right, and the last one is actual, and that's one Picasso really got into, where you put the things on there. You take real textures, and you just stick them right onto the artwork. And that makes some really cool effects, too. Never have been into that either. I just really like, not getting really interested in what's right now, really like working with what I see and expressing my feelings about it in the way that I handle the colors and the textures. And I know, that probably doesn't make any sense. But you get into this as much as I have, it does. I don't think I really thought about that much when I started out, but I think more than a lot of people, because I think I've always had a pretty good understanding of the abstraction of art, the way a lot of people have a good understanding of the abstraction of music, you know, music without words. It makes sense to them, even when there's no words about it. They just have this natural understanding. I think I've always been like that. This is getting some really interesting effects. Now I'm really getting into adding into it. I don't really see anything into it, so I think this is going to be what, as I said, most people call abstract, artists call non-objective or non-figurative. Probably just going to leave it that way and just work with that as colors and textures and lines and space and all the things that all paintings are about. But here, there's no distractions. You don't bring your biases to this kind of painting. You either like it or you don't like it because of the way it looks. Doesn't mean it's better than other kinds. There are some artists that really believe that. I think that whenever you're representing something that you see, well, that's what you're doing, so it's not really art. I don't agree with that at all. But artists are very opinionated. It's not better. It's just a category. It's just a category that a lot of artists prefer so that you aren't bringing in yourself into it. You're not saying, well, it's a horse. I like it because it's a horse. Well, it's a ballerina. I like it because it's a ballerina. It's a ballerina. I don't like ballerinas. You know, that doesn't come into it. You either like this because the way I'm reacting to these colors and what I'm building, or you don't. You don't have to. But you can't say it's because of what it looks like. And that's why a lot of artists prefer to work non-objective, non-figurative, or what most people call abstract. See, we don't really see this as abstract. We consider shapes, recognizable shapes that have been changed on purpose to be abstract. Like Picasso did a lot of that. Took faces, horses, all kinds of things, and made them so they look different from the way you see them, but you know that it's still a horse. You see that that's what it is. I'm getting some really interesting things. A lot of people ask, why do you talk when you're painting it and then hard? Well, it's not easy, but at the same time, I'm looking at it, but I'm also paying attention to talking at the same time, so get a lot of things to come up, and I like for my YouTubes to be very inventive just to really let them go, unlike my oil paintings. I'm finally getting ready to get to another floral. Wildflower, I love working with wildflowers. All those wonderful colors and textures is great. Getting some interesting things through here, and I haven't really done that much with the tissue. Maybe I'm going to do a little bit more. I'm going to have to pick it up off the floor because the ones in the box are kind of far away. I'm going to really bunch it up this time since I got some really heavy paint through here. See if something doesn't really show up. No, not really. No, just getting kind of, yeah, some interesting invented textures, but not anything that's really standing out. Yeah, can always go back into it. Lots of times I get these to a point where I just really like the way they look and I don't want to change them. As I often said, in my opinion, and in the opinion of a lot of artists, good art is a control between balance and accident. You decide certain things to do, but then things happen as you're doing them, and then you got to decide, do you want to keep them? Do you want to go further? You know, it's a very, very difficult thing. And I've been working at this forever, so the fact that I'm coming up with something that I'm really liking is practice, practice, practice. Just like practicing the piano. I've become so adept at reacting very quickly to colors and textures as they're going together into what I think is an interesting whole. And I shouldn't have gotten rid of that. I need that white. Like I said, control and accident. Don't like what I did right there. Yeah, I liked it better with the white. Okay. We've been going 9 minutes. I had a feeling this was probably going to be kind of a quick one. I like the way there's an emotion right through here. Oh, I do start to see something. It's kind of weird looking. I might want to bring it out. But look right through here. That kind of looks like some kind of serpent's mouth and eye. And then you start to see scales going here and it's wrapping around. Like, This movie we were watching the other night was really wild about a crocodile and a shark. It was a really weird science fiction thing. This is starting to look kind of like that crocodile jumping around. I don't know. I might bring that out. I think I'll kind of work around it because that's kind of fun. It might be fun to have this serpent. So I'm going to just do a little more through here and leave that kind of face area because I might want to do that. Maybe put a few more scales. I think that would be fun. I don't think I have a lot of fish and all when I do suggestions paintings when things just show up. But I don't think I have like a serpent like this. I may. I've done so many. But I do want to do a little more contrast and size and some accents. I always love red accents. I'll never forget the famous artist, Mae Stevens, judged the competition I was in. And when she was introduced to me, she gave my painting an award. She said, the red-green painter. She's right. Really am into those two complementary colors. Okay, I'm starting to get, I don't know, things that I'm doing aren't doing much of a sparkle. I really think I might do that, because I know it's a little hard to see, but I could easily bring that out, and it fits so well in with the rest of the space that this may not be a music without words. This may be one of my suggestions series. I'm getting towards the end now. Don't like to spend a tremendous amount of time on my YouTube ones. Not my oil paintings, they take forever. That's why I don't do them. I really don't want to do the time lapse, as I said before. I want to really talk and do something and really come up with something in a little while that I think is very interesting to look at. I think it would be nice to do that because there's modeling right through here. That's, you know, round shapes. It's not flat. It's actually moving around. I could pull that out even more. So I think I'm going to quit pretty soon and then work off camera because that's going to take a while. A lot of decisions to make about exactly how I want to do that. So that's going to take a little while. And it's been 12 minutes, so that's pretty long. So I think I will stop right there. Again, thanks for watching. Thank you. Please, the link to the painting will be at the top of the description. Link to my Etsy shop, website, and other sites that have my work.